Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan, and in this video we are going to discuss about a complete incremental data refresh in a Power BI dataset. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Let's get started. Incremental refresh enables very large datasets in Power BI with the following benefits. Refreshes are faster. Only the data that has changed needs to be refreshed. For example, refresh only the last 5 days of a 10-year dataset. Refreshes are more reliable. It is no longer necessary to maintain long running connections to violate source systems. Resource consumption is reduced. Less data to refresh reduces overall consumption of memory and other resources. Incremental refresh is now available to Power BI Pro, Premium and Shared subscription and datasets. Incremental refresh policies are defined in Power BI Desktop and applied when published to Power BI Service. There are important things to remember. Datasets are filtered by using Power Query DateTime parameter with the reserved case-sensitive names range start and range end. Query folding is also recommended. If the query folding is not possible, then it will take a lot of time to refresh the data. I have made a video about the query folding in Power BI. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen. Now coming back to this one, if the Power Query expression for the table doesn't refer to the parameters with the reserved name, that is range start and range end, the toggle is disabled. This is the toggle of incremental refresh. It will be disabled. You can't able to enable this option if the reserved name, range start and range end is not available on the parameters. The following example defines a refresh policy to store data for 5 full calendar years plus for the current year up to the current date, and they incrementally refresh 10 days of data. The first refresh operation loads historical data. Subsequent refreshes are incremental, and if scheduled to run daily, perform the following operations. So here in the picture here, I have taken the order date column for the 5 years to store the rows, and after that it will refresh only the last 10 days of data. So whenever it refreshes on a daily basis, it will add a new data of a new day and refresh 10 days up to the current date. Remove calendar years that are older than 5 years prior to the current date. For example, if the current date is January 1st, 2019, the year 2013 is removed. So it will consider only if the full calendar year is completed or a new calendar year begins. If the year is January 2020, then 2014 year will be removed. The first refresh in the Power BI service may take longer to import all 5 year calendar years. Subsequent refreshes may be finished in a fraction of time. The next option we have here is detect data changes. Incremental refreshes of 10 days is more efficient than full refresh of 5 years of data. However, it is possible to do even better. If you select the Detect Data Changes checkbox, you can select a date time column used to identify and refresh only the days where the data has changed. This assumes such column exists in the source system, which is typically for auditing purpose. This should not be the same column used to partition the data with the range start and range end parameters. The column which were used for the parameters should not be the same here in detect data changes. It should be a different column. The maximum value of this column is evaluated for each of the periods in the incremental range, that is for the 10 days. If it has not changed since the last refresh, there is no need to refresh the period. In the example, this could be reduced the days incrementally refreshed from 10 to around 2 days. Only refresh data in the last 10 days if the maximum value of the date time column changes. And the last option is only refresh complete days. Let's say your refresh is scheduled to run at 4 a.m. every morning. If data appears in the source system during these 4 hours, that is from morning 12 a.m. to 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m. and 4 a.m., you may not want to account for it. Some business metrics such as barrels per day or in oil and gas industry make no sense with the partial days. Even for the production output, for the daily output, we had to keep a track on a daily output, no, instead of making an hourly basis. Another example is refreshing data from a financial system where data for the previous month is approved on 12th calendar day of the month. You could set the incremental range to 1 month and schedule the refresh to run on the 12th day of the month. With this option checked, it would be example refresh January data on February 12th. Only after that you can able to consider the value of January. This is the Power BI file. In this I have the data from 1st of July 2018 to 30 June 2020. So here I have three visuals. One is for the this month, that is for the month of July 2020, and this is for the month of June 2020, and this all the data begins from 1st of July 2018 till 30 June 2020. Now let's go into the Power Query editor to create the parameters. So transform data. Basically, this is a transaction of sales quantity on a daily basis, and this is a timestamp column. First of all, we need to create two parameters. One is range start and then the range end. This is the reserved keyword, so we have to use the same name with this case sensitive. So manage parameter and then new parameter. Range start, and then you have to select the type date time. Any suggested value, you have to give a default value. So I have given the value from 1st of July 2018. Like the same way, you have to create one more by clicking new here. I have made a video about the manage parameters in Power BI. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen. Now coming back to this one, the range end. This I have given the current date the same way. Cancel this one. And after that, I use this column, timestamp column, and go to this date time filters, and then in custom filter, I use this basic here, and this is timestamp is after or equal to. Here you have to select the parameter from this drop down, and it is range start date, and here before, same thing from the parameter, you have to select here range end date. This is how you have to filter the data. After that, click OK. For now it will filter the data here, but this is not going to be the actual value which is going to deploy it on Power BI service. It is based on the data which you are going to select in the configuration menu of incremental refresh. As said in the theory time, it has to be enable the query folding. So I'm right clicking here, and then if you look at here, view native query, it means the query folding is enabled here. So this is done. So two things to consider here. One is the range start and range end. It has to be same name with the case sensitive, and then query folding has to be enabled. Once these two things are done, click apply and close, and then click on this here three dot icon of this table, more options, and then incremental refresh. And also you have one more option, go to modeling tab, and then click right click on the table, incremental refresh. So it will open up this window, and here you need to select the table. I'm going to select this one, INC refresh data, and you need to toggle on this one, incremental refresh. By default it will be turned off. Once this is on, and store rows where column timestamp, I started timestamp column in the parameter of range start and range end. So by default it has taken the column, and here I am saying it has to store 1 year data, whereas in the parameter I mentioned 2018, right? So here I am mentioning it has to store 1 year data and refresh rows where the column timestamp in the last 2 months. I want it to refresh for the last 2 months of data. Okay, so regarding these two things, we'll consider on later on stage. So once these two things are done, click on apply. Okay, now I'm going to publish this one. So once you have done all these things, publish. Success. Let's go into Power BI service. Now here I have two data here. So let's configure the gateway first. So clicking on the data set and then settings. I have made a video about the data gateway configurations. If you haven't seen that, just click on the link given on top of your screen. So now refreshing the data. The first time it will refresh the data and it will take some time because it has to take all the values from the data source. And then for the upcoming incremental refresh, it will just do it in a fraction of seconds. So let's open this file. If you look at this in Power BI, it is showing the value from 2018 July to 30th June. Whereas here, it has taken only from January 1st, 2019 to 30th June. The reason is because in incremental refresh, we are set to be store the records of the last 1 year. Now let's add some data and see how it works. Now opening this SQL server and adding the value of, say for example, 3 days of data. Let's refresh the data set. Done. Coming back here, refresh. So now the data is up to 3rd of July and we have this 3 day of data here. So we have considered the 2 months of data, right? So what will happen if we have made any changes on the previous date? Now let's do some update and deletion and we'll see how it reacts here. Let's delete some data. I'm going to delete the data from 2019 June to 2019 end of the June. So let's refresh the data. Refresh. If you look here, still we have the data of June month. There is no effect here because the reason is we have configured an incremental refresh to store the data of 1 whole year, but the refresh, incremental refresh, we have set up to only for the 2 months. So there is no effect here for the month of June on 2019. Now let's make some changes in the month of June. That is because the current month is July, so we are configured to refresh for the 2 months of data, so June and July. So I'm going to update the data of the March 31st and also the June 1st. Let's refresh the data. Refreshing the report. If you look at here, there is a change here. So we have a drop here on 1st June, that is 500. I have made two changes here, updates here. First of June and then 31st of May. So if you look at 31st of May, the value still it is 111, whereas I updated in SQL Server 500. Whereas in 1st of June, it is updated here as well, it is 500. Because we have set the incremental refresh for the 2 months. So current month is July and the previous month is June. It is taking whatever you configured over there, it is taking for the complete calendar month, complete calendar year. If you configured it to store the value of the 2 years of data, then it will consider this complete 2 years of data, that is 2018, 2019 and 2020. If it is 1 year of data, then 2020 is current year and then it will take only for the year of 2019. Now let's do some changes here. We have two more options in incremental refresh, opening again, detect data changes. It means if there is a data changes on that, I have set it to be for the 2 months, right? It will refresh all the values for the 2 months. Whereas we have this option detect data changes. If you click here, only refresh data in the last 2 months if the maximum value of this date time column changes. Here we have to select a different column. Timestamp I have used here for this one, increment data refresh time period. Here we have to select a different column I'm going to select here transdate. If there is a change in the value of the transdate column, date time column, then it will refresh the value. Okay, let's apply here and let's have a look at the changes. Once it's done, save and then publish again. Now I have added two more dates to this data, and let's update some data to see how it reacts with the detect data changes option. I am updating the transdate as well as the sales quantity of this date, 3rd of July. Now let's refresh the data. Let's refresh the report. There is no change here, because the reason is, if you look at this incremental refresh window, only refreshed data in the last 2 months if the maximum value of this date time column changes. Maximum value of this date time column means the maximum date we have here is 5th of July. We have not made any changes on the 5th of July. So if you make any changes on the 5th of July, or if we add one more row after the 5th of July, that is 6th of July, something else, then it will refresh all the data for the past 2 months. Let's update the data of 5th of July. So here I'm updating the data of 5th of July now. Now refreshing the data. Refresh the report. See, so we have got an update of 3rd of July and 5th of July, both of them as well. So 6655 5th of July and 4343 3rd of July. 4343 3rd of July, 6655 5th of July. So this is how it will work. Detect data changes. Now let's see one more option. Only refresh complete months. So I'm enabling this option and then apply all. Now publish the report. I have published the report. Now refresh the data. So now refreshing the report. There is no data available for this month of July, because we have enabled that option to refresh the data only if the month completes. See here again, only refresh complete month. So the current month which we are now, it is not complete, so it is not refreshing. So let's update some data in SQL Server. I am adding the data of a new record for 1st of August. Now let's refresh the data. Refresh the report. There is no data here for the month of July. Actually, it is taking the calendar month from the system. It's not taking the data from the database. So that's why it is not showing any value after the current month. So the value which is available here, it is just end of June 30. So there is no value available after June 30. If you look at this one, this for the last month, this for the current month, and this is the whole data without any filtration, even though here we have only till June 30. There is no data available for month of July as well as August. So this is all about the incremental refresh in Power BI dataset. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button. And also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.